Last class, we have studied about the light emitting diodes, and then in that we have studied about the double heterogeneous structure of LED and the surface emitting LED, edge emitting LED, and the quantum efficiency and LED power. And then we have derived the equation for that quantum efficiency and input power. And then we have solved problems related to the quantum efficiency and LED power. The laser diodes, so which are also called as light amplification by stimulated emission of radiation, which is a laser. So it is it comes in many forms, with varying dimensions. Optical fiber system uses the semiconductor laser diodes. There are many types of laser diodes are there. In that, semiconductor types of laser diodes are one of the types. And they are highly monochromatic, and light beam is very directional. Okay, they are monochromatic because the light which is generated is of only one color, and it depends. It is on only one band, wavelength band, and it is very directional, as well as it is coherent. That means the phases of the photons which are generated will be same. So it uses an amplification process. So that is your laser. The LED is something like it spreads the light in a wide range. It has a wide band so that it spreads the light, and it is useful for display purposes. So light, laser is not useful for display purposes. It is used to send the light for longer distance. So as it is the monochromatic and it is coherent. Okay. For that purpose, laser uses three concepts called as photon absorption, spontaneous emission, and stimulated emission, which we have seen in the first class of your optical sources. Okay, so we have already studied this absorption. We will just brief out in the next page. There is another concept called as population inversion, where the laser uses. Population inversion means the atoms or the molecules which are present at the higher energy states will be more compared to that of the atoms or molecules which are present at the lower energy state. So that is called as population inversion. There is no equilibrium concept here. If there is an equilibrium concept, the equal number of poles or the equal number of atoms will be present in lower energy state as well as in higher energy state. So, but in case of population inversion, so more number of atoms or molecules are present at the excited states are at the higher states compared to that of your lower states. That is your population inversion. Okay, because in order for the stimulated emission to occur, so population inversion is necessary. So stimulated emission uses the population inversion concept. I will explain this. Okay, so that is the thing. The laser transition process, whatever the first is absorption. What is absorption? We have studied that already. Absorption is, so whenever a molecule is present at the lower energy state, when the light is hit on it and it absorbs the light energy present in that light and jumps from lower energy state to the higher energy state. So that is absorption process. So laser uses this. Next is spontaneous emission. So whenever the molecule which is present at the higher energy state wants to come back to the lower energy state, it releases the energy in the form of light and then comes to the lower energy state. It is called as spontaneous emission, which the LED uses spontaneous emission. But laser uses spontaneous as well as stimulated emission. Stimulated emission is such that the whatever the light which is coming out here on the spontaneous emission, if it hits the another molecule which is at the higher energy state, and the higher energy state uses this energy and releases another photon, the photon which is incidented on it and the photon which is generated from it, if both are in phase, then they add up together, which leads to a concept called as amplification. When both are coherent, they add up together and amplification process starts. Again, these will hit on the another molecule. Again, the light is generated and they will be in phase with them. So if that is the case, if they are in phase, they add up together. If they are not in phase, they cancel each other. So we should design such that if they add up in phase, laser will come into picture. That is your stimulated emission. So laser uses all these three concepts, but LED uses only two concepts, absorption and spontaneous emission. Okay. Okay. Stimulated emission, that is this one. Stimulated emission. The same, whatever I explained, it is presented here. In the absence of the stimulated emission, example, lasing condition, electrons and holes may coexist in a proximity to one another without recombining for a certain time, termed the upper state lifetime or the recombination time. So before recombining, they will be present, the electrons and holes or the molecules which will be present there. They will be, before recombining, they take some second, that is nanoseconds of time before they recombine. The nearby photon with the energy equal to recombination energy can use the recombination by stimulated emission. So before they recombine, if any photon is hit on them, again, they will generate another photon like that. Okay. So, yeah, whatever I explained, it is there. Electrons and holes will be injected across the junction. So we'll see how that stimulated emission happens. Yeah, spontaneous and stimulated emission will occur only in direct band gap semiconductors. Direct band gap semiconductors are gallium, aluminium, arsenide, gallium, aluminium, arsenide material, whether the ternary alloy or the quaternary alloy. So those are all the band gap semiconductor, especially. So that we have seen what is direct band gap and indirect band gap. So indirect band gap are your silicon and germanium. Okay. Next is the laser diode modes and threshold condition. Okay. For optical fiber communication systems requiring a bandwidth greater than 200 megahertz, the semiconductor injection laser diode is preferred over LED. So only in the cases where the bandwidth required is greater than 200 megahertz, normally laser is preferred. These are the characteristics. You can consider these are the characteristics. If that is asked, you can write it down. So another characteristics are the response time will be very high. That means very quick, less than 1 nanoseconds. Spectral width of 2 nanometer or less. So that means it is very directional beam is generated from your laser. That is spectral width. And the power will be more. Power, you can easily couple from one fiber to another fiber. Coupling efficiency is more because it is very directional. You can easily connect one fiber and another fiber so that the light passes through them. If it is a LED, as it generates the light in wide range, then it is difficult to couple. So this coupling efficiency is more in case of your laser. Okay, there are two configuration exists here. One is the Fabry Pierret resonator, another one is the distributed feedback laser. Okay, so modes of the next is the modes of the cavity. These are all the characteristics are requirement characteristics actually. These you can write down in characteristics. Then next is the modes of cavity. Modes of cavity means the cavities which are used for the generation of the light. So in which way you take that particular light, whether you are taking laterally, whether you are taking it on a longitudinal basis, whether on a traverse basis. So that is the modes of cavity. So first we'll go through the light beam. Light beam, if you analyze, it consists of both electric field and magnetic field, which are perpendicular to each other. So they are 90 degrees apart. They are orthogonal. So light beam consists of electric field and magnetic field, which are orthogonal to each other. That is one thing. So there exists, there are two types of modes. One is a transverse electric, another one is transverse magnetic modes. What is transverse electric? Transverse electric is your electric field will be perpendicular to the direction of propagation. That is transverse electric. Transverse magnetic is the one where the magnetic field is perpendicular to the direction of propagation of the wave. That is transverse magnetic. So both chances of transverse electric as a transverse magnetic modes exist. This can be seen only if you analyze the light beam in depth. You see the electron field pattern, electric field patterns and magnetic field patterns, then you can say whether this is a transverse electric field or a transverse magnetic field. Okay, so within this, then the way in which you take that particular light out of the laser is again subdivided. So these normally exist, these will be there inbuilt within the light. But how you take that particular light out, then again it leads to another modes within the cavity. So those are these three things. One is the longitudinal way, another one is the lateral way, another one is the traverse. So what is longitudinal, lateral and traverse? We'll see that. Okay, so within the transverse electric and transverse magnetic, see this. This is the lateral, this is in plane. This is the PN junction, maybe your this is your plane, which is normal to your plane, if the light is coming out in this direction. If it is coming out in perpendicular to the PN junction, whatever it is there, that is our junction is there, then it is the transverse mode. This is the transverse side. This is the lateral side. If the light is coming out like this, and if it's coming out like this in this way, it is a longitudinal size. Okay, that is a longitudinal mode. So within your light beam, there exists transverse electric and transverse magnetic. The transverse electric and transverse magnetic fields, how they come out of your laser is again be calculated based on whether it is a transverse mode, lateral mode, or a longitudinal mode. Okay, that is this. Yeah, first is a longitudinal mode related. It depends on the length of the cavity, because on the sideways, if the length is more, then more longitudinal waves will come out. Okay, that is longitudinal mode. Lateral mode is in this. These modes lies in the PN junction. It depends on the sidewall preparation of the cavity. Okay, so it determines the shape of the lateral profile. So this side, the light which is coming out in line with the laser is a lateral mode. Some of the light will come out. So you are sending light, some of the light will come in this direction, very fractionally will come out on the parallel. Those we will also consider. Another one is a traverse mode. So it is the associated with the EM field, and it is on the beam in perpendicular, in direction, perpendicular to the plane of PN junction. Perpendicular to the plane of PN junction. So even though your laser is very directional, some amplitude will be distributed. If you observe the electric field and magnetic field of the beam which is present in the light, if they are on the traverse direction, then we will say that as a traverse mode. If they are in this direction, electric or magnetic field within the light, then it will say that on a longitudinal direction. In this side, it is a lateral direction. So it depends on the electric field and magnetic field directions with respect to your laser. That is the modes of your laser. We can explain that if it is asked. Okay, so laser mode, diode modes. That is another concept. So there are two configurations of laser. The two ways in which the laser is built, main two ways are, one is Fabry-Pierret resonator. Another one is DFB laser. So Fabry-Pierret resonator or Fabry-Pierret laser, both are same. So DFB is distributed feedback laser. So these are two important with respect to your exam. Either they will ask Fabry-Pierret laser or they may ask a DFB laser. Okay. We'll see Fabry-Pierret resonator in this class. Okay. So this, just go through this diagram. These are the junctions. This is another junction. This is another junction. Normally, it is a heterojunction. There are. You can use a homojunction also in case of a laser. Assume that it is a double heterogeneous structure also. Maybe two to four layers. So electrons will come from this side. Holes will come this side. Or you can make this as a P material and holes will come this. Electrons will come to the center layer. Okay. So this means that this is your active region. Here the confinement region, carrier is confined, optical and carrier confinement layers. In case of optical and carrier confinement layers, so we have seen the operation of laser is same with respect to the LED with few changes. So same carrier confinement layers and optical confinement layers, we have studied. What is carrier confinement? Carrier will be confined to the active layer, and the light which is generated will be confined within the waveguide. Within the waveguide, it will not go out. Then it is optical confinement. So we have seen that with respect to LED, same here also, electrons and holes will come to the active layer and they will recombine. Once they will recombine, they generate a light, and that light should be directional. That is your laser. In case of LED, the light is spreads out. In case of laser, it should be directional. So for that purpose, we have used a dielectric reflecting surfaces over completely. So at the last surfaces, we have a reflecting layers which act as a resonating cavity, which is extra compared to that of your LED. Other things are same thing. Cavity sides. This is one rough cut is used because the light should not come out from this side. So that is why the rough cut has been used here. But it is coated with the reflecting surfaces. We'll explain that. So other things are same. This is same. This is same. This is also same. The light will also come out in the active layer. That is also same. But the light which is coming out should be very directional. So this is lateral size, longitudinal size, traverse size. Okay. So whatever the light which is coming out, if you analyze that, if you analyze the light beam, intensity pattern of the light beam in the lateral condition, lateral way, it looks like this. Okay. But things which are coming out parallelly, that is perpendicular, that is traverse. So its amplitude distribution is somewhat like this. So it is the same, single light beam only, analyzed in this direction, one is this, and analyzed in this direction, this is the one. So one is parallel, this is parallel, this thing which is coming here, which is, that is parallel to it. This is perpendicular, whatever is being plotted here, it is perpendicular light beam. Single light beam analyzed in two way. Okay, optical output to be coupled into the fiber. This is the one which goes to the fiber. Okay, these are the sizes, dimensions. The one we have to explain only is this one, the dielectric reflecting surface, which is extra compared to that of LED. We'll go through that now. Okay, before that, you just note down the cavities, then dimensions, longitudinal dimension, lateral dimension, and traverse dimension. So this is lateral dimension, traverse dimension. This is longitudinal dimension. Okay, so then what is the resonant cavity which is at the edges? These resonant cavity is called as a Fabry-Perret resonant cavity. These are the reflecting surfaces. There are two reflecting surfaces which are placed, which acts as the mirrors. Okay, these are coated with some reflectivity. There will be some coating. So this coating will act as the it will be used for reflection. Okay, so reflecting facets are here. The light will be reflected here and there, and it is coated in such with some reflectivity, such that some part of the light is always sent back, but some part of the light will be transmitted out. How, which light we will transmit out and which light we will send again within the cavity is based on the design. Okay, here what in Fabry-Perret resonator people will do is the wavelength of the photon which is generated, the some after some recombination, so electrons and holes will recombine, they generate the light. The light which is generated again hits some another another electron or hole, and again it will generate the photon. The photons which are generated in the active layer, if the wavelength of that particular photon is the integer multiple of the length, if the length is 4 millimeter, if the wavelength is integer multiple of that, that is, if the length is 4 micrometer, if the light is generated is 8 micrometer, then it will allow the light to pass through there. Okay, it will not allow, it will allow only the light which is the integer multiple of the length, that is 4 micrometer or 6. If it is 6 micrometer, it will allow 6 micrometer light, 12 micrometer light, 18 micrometer light, 24 micrometer light, like that. That means the length, the wavelength which is generated should be integer multiple of it. Okay, so that is the thing. Otherwise, it will send the light again back. Okay, once they are integer multiple of the light is allowed to pass through the reflectors, what happens? They have the same wavelength or the same frequency. So when they have the same frequency, the same wavelength, they will add up together because their phases are same. So if the phases are same, they will add up together and there is really amplification happens. If they allow all the light to come out, which are not in same wavelength, not in integer multiples of the length, then what happens? They will add up additively. They will destruction will happen and the amplification will not. So you will not allow the light to come out. If it is the integer multiple of the length between the reflectors, we'll allow them. Then the allowed light, what happens is, if it is integer multiple of length, the both wavelengths will be almost the same. That is integer multiple of wavelengths. If it one is a 4 micrometer, another one is 8 micrometer, phases will be same. If the phases will be same, then they add up together. Once they add up together, then there will be a concept of amplification. Then amplification will happen and the light is generated in a directional fashion. Otherwise, you'll send them back. That is your resonator, Fabry-Perret resonator. Okay, so this is the one wherever it is quoted here, right? So it will allow only the light which is coming out here, which is the integer multiple of the your reflecting surfaces which are quoted down here. So the light will come in this direction only. Okay, that is your resonator cavity. I'll explain that. Two flat partially reflected mirrors, they will act as a mirror, are directed towards each other to enclose a Fabry-Perret resonant cavity. So in the above figure. So the mirror facets are constructed by making two parallel facets along the natural cleavage planes of the semiconductor crystal. Purpose of the mirror is to establish a strong optical feedback in the longitudinal direction. Purpose of the mirror is to establish a strong optical feedback because the light will come back again within the cavity if it is not the integer multiple of length. Then what happens? That light will again incident on the molecules which are present, and again it generates the photon. So it acts as a feedback for the generation of the another photon, which is an integer multiple of wavelength. So that is why we will consider that as a feedback mechanism. The unwanted emission is not taken out, which will not be taken out because that's why there is a rough side, which I explained earlier. There are rough edges are made. Okay, mechanism, whatever I explained, it has been put here. Light travels back and forth within the cavity. The electric field of the light will interfere with the successive round trips. Round trip means this will hit the surfaces, right? Then it will come back. That is the round trips. Those wavelengths that are integer multiples of the cavity length interfere constructively so that their amplitudes will add when they exit the device at the right side. This is what I explained. They are the wavelengths that are integer multiples of the cavity length interfere constructively so that their amplitudes will add and they exist. They exit from the right side. All other wavelengths interfere destructively, so there will not be a concept of amplitude within the cavity, amplification within the cavity. The wavelengths at which the photons are added constructively are called as resonant frequency. Spontaneously emitted photons that have wavelengths at these resonant frequencies reinforce themselves after multiple trips through the cavity, so that the optical field becomes very strong. Okay, spontaneous emitted photons that have wavelengths at these resonant frequencies, those are called as, that's where your optical field becomes very strong. So there has been a graph which has been put for this one. If you observe here, that is the intensity of the light beam on the y-axis. On the x-axis, you have wavelength. At different wavelengths, you observe here. At one of the wavelength, we will consider this as a resonating wavelength. If you observe here, what the photons intensity is very directional. So it's a very directional beam you can observe at this point. Here also, there is a very directional beam you can observe. On the other sides, the beam is not directional. Okay. If the beam is not directional, then it works as a LED. So there is no way. So you have to choose a wavelength such that where actually your intensity is very directional. So that is the design. So that can be controlled through your reflectors. That is your Fabry-Perret resonator. So you can code them properly such that they will allow this. The design of Fabry-Perret cavity will actually tell you the which wavelength you can operate so that the laser beam which is coming out will be very directional. Okay. So that's what is being there. So we'll see the DFB laser in the next class. So I left with few concepts only in your module 3 with respect to the optical sources. So we'll see that in the next classes. Okay, I hope you have understood to some extent, but Fabry-Perret resonator is very important. Next is a distributed feedback laser. That is also important. We'll see that in next class. Okay. I hope you have understood. If you have any questions, you can ask through chat. Or if you don't have any questions, I will stop my share. I will record your attendance. Just be there for 1 or 2 minutes. Yeah, I have recorded your attendance. Yeah, thanks for attending the class. I will end my session.